Hello all, welcome back. So this is the second lecture of module 2. So in this lecture we are going to discuss about gauges. So what is a gauge? Gauge is simply the width between two rails. Based on the width between two rails, gauges are broadly divided into four types: broad gauge, standard gauge, meter gauge and narrow gauge. So we will discuss in detail about these gauges in the following slides. As I mentioned, gauges is the clear distance between inner or running faces of two track wheels. As the distance between two track wheels varies, the gauges are differently named. So we will look at in detail about these gauges. So the different gauges that are used in India for the railway network system are: first one is the standard gauge or broad gauge. The gauge width of this broad gauge system is 1.76 meter. And the second type is meter gauge, and the gauge width is 1 meter. And the third one is narrow gauge. The gauge width is 0.762 meter. And the last one is a feeder track gauge or light gauge, and the width of this gauge is 0.610 meter. So, what are the selection criteria of gauges? We will discuss about the selection criteria of gauges. First point is the cost of construction. The cost of construction increases slightly with the increase in gauge width. So it's directly proportional. The cost is directly proportional to the gauge width. The second one is volume and nature of traffic. Heavier the loads and high speeds require wider gauges. For the smooth movement of heavier vehicles, it requires wider gauges. Third point is development of area. We all know that we are familiar with broad gauges and standard gauges. In the places where population is very low or the areas of thinly populated area, narrow gauges are preferred than broad gauges or standard gauges. Next point is physical features of the country. Usually broad gauges are used in plain terrains and narrow gauges are adopted where low traffic is happening and the places near to the hilly areas, and the hilly railways like Himalayan railways adopted this narrow gauge as their gauge width. The last point is speed of movement. Increased speed requires increased gauge width. That is, we already discussed that in the first point. For heavier traffic, for the heavier loads, it requires wider gauges. And for the speedy movement, we all know that most of us may be familiar with the Himalayan railways. They are slow moving vehicles because of this narrow gauge mechanism. If we want to move the locomotives in a higher speed, we have to provide the broad gauge or standard gauge. The next heading is uniformity of gauges. Why we prefer a uniform pattern in the gauges of railway network system? Delay, cost and hardship in transshipping passengers and goods from vehicles of one gauge to another can be avoided if we follow a uniform pattern. Breakage of goods can be avoided. Difficulties in loading and unloading, labor expenses, etc. can be avoided if we follow a uniform pattern throughout the country. Large sheds for storing goods can be avoided. Surplus wagons of one gauge cannot be used on another gauge. This can be avoided if we follow the same gauges throughout the country. Locomotives can be used effectively on all tracks. We all know that the Himalayan railways won't run in our broad gauge system. So if we follow the same gauges all over the country, we can use the same locomotive for effectively and efficiently. It will be expensive to change to another gauge at a later stage. Some of us may heard that the Tenmala rail track has been modified to broad gauge from meter gauge after a long time. So those expenses can be eliminated if we follow the same gauge throughout the country. So that's all with the second lesson of the second module. So today we discussed about the gauges, the different types of gauges that we use in the railway network system, and Why we raised an argument that we should follow a uniform pattern in the gauges, and we discussed about the advantages of various systems. So see you in the next lesson with another topic. Until then, bye, take care.